and welcome to FIA Pure Motorsport. On this week's episode, we'll crown the world champion in karting. We'll introduce you to Ferrari Academy driver Maya Weug. Plus, we'll have great cross-country action from Baja, Poland, and much, much more from the FIA world of motorsports. For the first time in 7 years, FIA karting is back in Le Mans for the grandest prize of them all, the world champion for KZ Gearbox drivers. It will also be the final event in the 13th annual Karting Academy Trophy. It's time for a showdown in the Academy Trophy as the world's brightest and best young talents square up in equal machinery for the pride of their nation. Guillaume Bouzard of Luxembourg and Arthur Dorison of France are the best place to win the title. With the tight first corner at Le Mans, a clean start is hard to imagine, but Dubnitsky and Roos make a textbook launch down the first corner with everybody else moving rationally into pursuit mode. Title contender Guillaume Bouzard is passed by the resurgent Jindrich Pazel, who along with Dorison is making amazing progress. But as the laps count down, Dorison is heading closer to the top step. On lap 13, he overtakes Dubnitsky for second, which would be enough to clinch the lead for point standings by a single point with six laps still remaining. On lap 16, he puts the win and the title beyond doubt with the same convincing move on Weichselbäume to grab the lead. With the loss of momentum for the Austrian evident, Dubnitsky pounces and moves up into second position. So Arthur Dorison, racing on his home circuit, is able to steal both the victory and the title at home, the first French driver ever to win this illustrious crown. For the fans in the grandstands, it's the perfect end to a terrific season, as is too for the Frenchman Arthur Dorison. Guillaume Bouzard finishes second in the final standings, with Colombia's Matias Orihuela third. For tension, suspense, and intrigue, nothing beats the KZ World Championship Final. With champions from Europe and the world, direct drive and gearbox alike, and even ex-Formula One driver Jaime Alguersuari taking on the toughest race in the world, the winner will truly earn the title of world champion. Pole sitter Simo Puhaka leads Victor Gustafsson and Jeremy Iglesias into Turn 1 with Pedro Hiltbrand, Senne van Valstein, and Emilien Dehner in close range. But at the end of the lap, Gustafsson has taken the lead and Iglesias has almost joined him at the sharp end of the field. The young generation is in great form as Lorenzo Trevisanuto found himself battling with Stan Pexen to Tuukka Tapanen. Even Adrian Renaudin can't hold them off, whilst up the road, Hiltbrand and Dehner are tripping over each other, allowing Senne van Valstein to make one of the moves of the season at the final corner, which leaves Hiltbrand nowhere to go as he runs wide. Iglesias senses a gap looming ahead of him and dives inside Puhaka, which allows Milel to take advantage of the Finn as well. A little later, Iglesias catches his teammate in the lead and his best chance to take it comes in lap 16, but as they don't want to hit each other, the Frenchman bails out. This is invitation enough for Noah Milel, number 31, and he claims second position just two corners later. Tony Kart seems like they are on the rise as Simo Puhaka makes his bid to end his career on the podium, but just as he makes his move, Iglesias retaliates and the Finn is vanquished. No matter what pressure his opponents apply, the Swede does not let his lead slip away, and after one of the toughest seasons of his entire career, Victor Gustafsson prevails against all odds and expectations to become world champion. Victor Gustafsson, the new world champion, Noah Milel from Sweden comes in second, and Jeremy Iglesias from France completes the podium in third. My Maya Weug is unique in many ways. She's competed under three different flags in her racing life so far, and she is the first female racing driver to attend the Ferrari Driver Academy. This season, she's racing in the F4 Italian Championships with the Iron Lynx team and under the Belgian flag.
I was born in Spain, but then my dad is Dutch, my mom is Belgian, so it's a mix. I feel like all three of them, so I can't choose really.
This is the 18-year-old's second year in Formula 4, and just like many of her male colleagues, Maya started out in karting.
My dad was doing it for fun, going to the track, and I always went with him. And one day I got for Christmas a kart, and since then I just fell in love with it and never stopped.
After competing in her birth country of Spain for a number of years, Weug branched out into European karting in 2016, where she won the WSK Final Cup in the mini category. A string of solid performances throughout these years in karts attracted the attention of the FIA Women in Motorsports Commission, who invited the then 16-year-old driver along with 19 other girls to compete in the Girls on Track Rising Stars program, with the reward for winning this shootout being a place in the Ferrari Driver Academy.
Yeah, that was my opportunity to make the step, and now I'm with Iron Lynx, Iron Dames and the Ferrari Driver Academy thanks to the FIA Women Motorsport, so it was amazing for me.
After months of intense preparation, training, scrutiny and pressure, Maya Weug was selected to become the first ever female student of the world famous Ferrari Driver Academy.
I mean, we work a lot. I'm there every week, every day. I live near Ferrari, so we do gym, so physically we are very prepared. Then we also do meetings and technical training to be as prepared as possible when we come into the race weekend.
But the step from karting to single-seater racing is a big one for any driver. Maya was no exception. Despite a pair of rookie podiums, she was unable to score any points during her first season.
My goal is to improve from last year. Get better at what I did wrong last year and just don't make the same mistakes.
In her second season, her progress is clear to see. She has already scored 8 times, regularly finishing the races in the top third of the leaderboard. All the hard work and dedication she puts into her sport is paying off.
She's very focused about the work, especially during the weekend, the race weekend, and she's a really pleasure with the work with Maya. I think the future for she is that will be really, really good. I think this season will be the final season for her to close the history from the beginner to the for the future professional driver. I think she will be a really good driver in the future, especially for the professional.
I think you have to work hard, that's the main thing, and follow your dreams, never give up. At the end, when you put your helmet on, we're all drivers, so it doesn't make a difference. It's difficult to say, you know, but I think it's just good as many girls as possible to get there. It will help to younger girls to start racing as well, so I'm not the only one, there's so many girls already doing that, so yeah.
Forty drivers from 25 different nations take to the track for the fifth round of the FIA Certified Italian F4 Championship at the Red Bull Ring. It's an eventful weekend in Spielberg. 4 races are held for the first time this season. Kimi Antonelli leads in the overall standings with a 36-point cushion over Rafa Camara. Alex Dunn, who is currently in excellent form, is in third place. New in the F4 Italian Championship is the American Ugo Ugochukwu, who immediately qualified for the first row of the grid and is starting next to his Prima Racing teammate Rafael Camara. Camara with the best start. From the second row of the grid, Taylor Barnard shoots forward and attacks Ugochukwu. After the first turn, the Brit passes him for second place and the American gets pressure from Wharton and Alex Dunn. They enter the bend side by side. Wharton and Ugochukwu have to swerve to the outside, and Dunn moves up into third place. In turn 4, Ivan Dominguez spins and takes Alfio Spina into the gravel. After the safety car phase, Barnard immediately attacks the leading Camara and is successful. In the next corner, Kamara is too close to Barnard and loses his front wing, which slides under his car. Alex Dunn takes advantage of the situation and passes both drivers. James Wharton does the same and takes second place. Without a front wing, Kamara slows down and Barnard drops back as well. Kamara heads into the pit lane and US Racing's Nikhil Bora and Ugo Chukwu move up into third and fourth places respectively. While Dunn and Wharton can pull away, Nikhil Bora and Ugo Chukwu have a great fight for third place, with Ugo Chukwu coming out on top with a nice maneuver. He then tries to get past James Wharton, but Wharton successfully fends off his attacks until the finish line. Alex Dunn takes his second win of the season, James Wharton finishes in second, and in his first F4 Italian race, Ugo Chukwu finishes on the podium in third. In the second race, Kimi Antonelli celebrates a lights to flag victory. Rafael Kamara is second, and Alex Dunn with another podium finish in third. In the third race of the weekend, Kimi Antonelli and Ugo Chukwu are in the front row of the grid. Taylor Barnard and Kasper Slutska are directly behind them in the second row. Antonelli with a great start. Ugo Chukwu tries to defend second place, but gets a lot of pressure from Taylor Barnard, who overtakes the American driver. Also, Konrad Laursen takes fourth place from Stuttgart. Antonelli is still leading, but all the drivers are close together. Too close. In a tight turn, Taylor Barnard touches the rear wheel of the Italian with his front wing and damages his tire. The tire loses air and Antonelli can no longer control his car and has to let the field pass. Barnard now leads ahead of Stuka with Larsen, followed by two more Prima Racing drivers, Ugo Chukwu and Charlie Wurz. Here's the decisive scene again, not only for Antonelli, but also for Barnard, who damages his front wing. While the Englishman slows down and has to give up the race to Stuka, Kimi Antonelli finally arrives in the pit lane for a tire change. Barnard is falling further and further behind, while Stuka maintains his lead position. Ugo Chukwu, number three, and Konrad Laursen fight for second place. In the end, the American has the better end for himself. Kasper Stuka earns his second Italian Formula 4 win of the season, Ugo Chukwu with another podium finish, and Konrad Laursen completes the podium in third. In the last race, Alex Dunn crowns his successful weekend with another victory. Kimi Antonelli secures second place and important points in the overall standings. Ugo Chukwu takes his third podium finish in third place. Kimi Antonelli extends his lead in the overall standings to 61 points. Alex Dunn is now only 4 points behind Rafael Kamara. The eighth round of the Formula Regional European Championship by Alpine took place at the Red Bull Ring in Spielberg, Austria. The first two races were marked by many interruptions. In the end, the Van Amersfoort Racing drivers celebrated an unexpected double victory. With two laps left to go, they were still in second and fourth place. Then Kaz Havercourt overtook Pierre-Louis Chauvet, who had been leading for a long time, and took the lead after moving up from 14th on the grid. His teammate Joshua Dufek first overtook Dino Baganovic to advance to third place, and then he passed Pierre-Louis Chauvet shortly before the finish line to take second place with the lead of 1/13 of a second. In the second race of the weekend, Adrien David celebrated a lights-to-flag victory. The Frenchman controlled the action from the very beginning and had little competition throughout the race. Second place went to Dino Baganovic, who thus extended his lead in the overall standings ahead of Gabriel Mini, who came only fourth. Joshua Dufek completed his good race weekend in Austria with another place on the podium. The sixth stop of the Goodyear FIA European Truck Racing Championship took place at the Circuit Zolder in Belgium. Although Norbert Kish had a comfortable lead in the overall standings and has already celebrated 11 wins in the first five rounds, the weekend showed how balanced the championship is with four different winners in four races. In the first race, Sascha Lenz took the lead from Kish at the start and never really relinquished it. Although Kish turned up the heat, Lenz managed to keep the Hungarian at bay. In the second race, the start decided the victory. Jochen Hans snatched the lead from pole sitter André Kurzim with a superb start. He pulled away from the field behind and disappeared down the road to secure an unchallenged win. The third race was again a clear affair for Norbert Kish. The Hungarian celebrated his 12th win of the season with a lights to flag victory. Jochen Hans and Sascha Lenz finished second and third behind Kish. In the fourth and final race of a successful weekend in Zolders, Adam Latchko prevailed. Antti Horto won the 2022 FIA European Drag Racing Championship title in the top fuel category. Reaching the final at the last event of the season was enough for Horto to do so. There, the Finn lost to Susanna Kallen. For Kallen, it was her second consecutive victory, and she also claimed the win at the Hockenheimring. In the final standings, Kallen finishes second with rookie Ida Zetterström rounding out the podium. Polish veteran Krzysztof Hovochits and co-driver Łukasz Kurzeja dominated the Kolumna Medica Baja Poland, winning all five timed sections on a three-day event to seal the victory in their X-Raid-built Mini John Cooper Works rally by a huge margin of 17 minutes 59 seconds. Title favorite Yazid Al-Raji's challenge for maximum FIA World Cup points ended abruptly in the third stage when his Toyota Hilux became engulfed in fire and was completely destroyed in the incident. The Baja Poland was also the final event of the FIA European Cup for cross-country Bajas. Polish driver Michał Maluszynski arrived in Szczecin with a three-point cushion over Portugal's João Ferreira in the battle for the FIA European Cup driver's title. Ferreira and co-driver David Monteiro managed to pip the Pole and his wife Julita to the runner-up spot by 54.9 seconds. The result also meant that Ferreira clinched the FIA European Cup Drivers' Championship by 4 points. If you look at the team names on the cars in the FIA European Historic Rally Championship, one thing immediately stands out. With many teams, you talk about the Mecklers, the Myers, or the Grahams. In no other sport do you meet so many couples who do the sport together.
Yeah, it's just lovely to do stuff together. And doing motorsport is something where the team's important as well. So it's lovely that we can kind of do that together and do something that we enjoy and rely on each other's expertise.
I think it's one of the best sports to see how a relationship works in all conditions. Sometimes you win, sometimes you lose, so you have everything from very down to very high.
Gerda Zoyner has been sitting next to Carl Wagner in the yellow Porsche 911 SE since 2009.
I think we are completely different in lot of things, but at the end, we are always a good team.
A very good team. The two of them have already won 4 times together, but driving in a rally together does not only bring them trophies and awards.
It brought a lot to our relationship because I think this is a job. He has to listen to me, and he in private life or also we always also working together. He doesn't listen so much like in the race car. And he has to talk to me because normally if he is not in good mood or he is angry or whatever, and this is normal in life, he doesn't talk to me. And during race we are a team all together with the mechanics, the whole team, and he has to talk to me any time a day.
In rallying, communication between driver and co-driver is vital, and this can also be translated into a partnership.
So I think it's communication and being able to really listen to the other person whenever it really matters. In fact, some of our friends in the historic rallying, particularly the wives, have reflected that maybe during competition in historic rallying is the only time the husband really listens.
Ernie and Karen Graham have been married for over 30 years, and it's almost as long ago that they drove a rally as a team for the first time. What used to be unusual is now quite normal at the historic rallies, couples competing together.
I think it's because it is a high degree of trust in the car, and you achieve that perhaps over a long marriage, perhaps. But there are lots of women co-drivers generally, so yes, it's a good thing to do. The couples who play together stay together, so that's always been our, that was true.
That was also the thought when Stefan and Renata Meyer were looking for a common hobby.
We looked for a sport we can do together. And in the beginning, we make some oriental rallies, so you have to look for the way. And she drove, and I was on the co-driver, because she can't read papers and during driving, because she got a little bit sick. And she learned it, and so we changed the cars, and I want to drive a little bit faster, so we began in 85 rallying.
And as they say in rallying, if you can handle the disagreements in the car, you can handle them in life outside the car.
We are now married for 32 years, and I think we will have it to the end. So, as we say it at the church, since we die.
The seventh round of the FIA European Historic Rally Championship took place in the northwest of Spain in the beautiful province Asturias. In Category 1, for cars built before 1969, Ernie and Karen Graham celebrated their sixth win of the season and took the title in Category 1.
One right, three houses, turn four left at junction. One right, three houses, turn four left at junction.
In their Ford Escort twin cam, the British couple posted the fastest Category 1 times on all six stages of Day 2 and finished the Rally de Asturias Historico 8th overall. In Category 2 for cars built between 1970 and 75, Britain's Will Graham and his Irish co-driver James O'Brien finished 6th overall in the Ford Escort RS 1800 and won Category 2.
Two left and two left. It's a turn four right. We turn four right. Into two right. 40. Long one right time.
This was Graham's second win in a row. In Category 3 for cars built between 1976 and 1981, Zippo and Nicola Arena went into Day 2 with a comfortable lead, not only in the category, but also in the overall standings. But that did not mean that the Italians took it easy. They set the fastest times on all six stages of Day 2. Zippo took his fifth Category 3 win of the season to seal the Category 3 title for the second year in a row, and the win in the Rally de Asturias Historico. The Italian crew finishes 4 minutes 42 seconds ahead of Antonio Sainz and Carlos Risco in the Subaru Legacy Turbo 4-wheel drive. The Spanish duo moves ahead of Mats Mirzel and Esco in their Ford Sierra RS Cosworth 4x4 to secure the Category 4 win for cars built between 1982 and 1990. Mirzel and Unita finish 3rd amongst the ETRC contenders overall and 2nd in Category 4.
Oh.
Zippo and Nicola Arena win the Rally de Asturias Historico ahead of Spain's Antonio Sainz and Carlos Risco. Third place goes to Mats Mirsel and Esko Juntila from Finland. That's it for today. On our next episode of FIA Pure Motorsport, we present the all-important decisions of this motorsport season. We'll show you the champions of the FIA Autocross Championship, and we'll crown the European Truck Racing Champion. Till next time, take care, everybody, and ciao.